getting into the very important metric, ROIC. So to calculate ROIC, we've actually had to develop an entire tab that will do this. So we're going to start with Celanese here. What we need to do to calculate ROIC here at the bottom, we need to determine the net operating profit less adjusted taxes for the business. And what we're going to do is take that and divide by invested capital to get the ROIC. So the first part, the NOPLAT, we need to get adjusted EBIT and minus the cash taxes from that. So what we're doing is we're taking the original operating income or EBIT value that they're reporting. We're going to adjust that, like we talked about in Chapter 7, how to make adjustments to get the adjusted EBIT, which is really the recurring operating income for the business. So to do that, we take the operating income in 2010, which is $503 million. I'll show you where to get that. We're going to go to the income statement for Celanese, and we're going to operating income or operating profit of 503. So we're taking the sales, taking out all costs, taking out all the expense related costs, leaving us operating profit, which you're going to see that there's some stuff in there that we want to get rid of. So we start with a 503. We're going to add back any non-cash expenses, which in the case here, there are none. We're then going to subtract any non-operating or recurring income. So if it's not recurring or it's not operating, we're getting rid of it. So in this case, any other gains and charges we're taking care of. So we did have $46 million in charges, so we're going to add that back. It was originally being taken away and it's not operating, so we're going to add it back. They also had foreign exchange losses, so we're going to add that back. And then they had a gain on the disposition of businesses and assets, so we're going to take that away. So we then need to add back any interest expenses, which are included in the expense ratio here. So within this area here, they're actually including lease expenses or operating leases for about $160 million. So we're going to add that back as well. So now we're getting the adjusted EBIT of the business in 2010 of about $704 million. Now, to get the lease expenses, we're actually going to go to the contractual obligations section of the notes.